Willis plans to move full steam ahead despite all of this on trying to indict, or excuse me, for trying the former president. CBS News Atlanta reported on this. They wrote that Fulton County District Attorney Fani Willis has asked a judge to set a trial date of March 4th, 2024. For former President Donald Trump and his 18 co-defendants. Willis has also asked to schedule arraignments for the defendants for the week of September 5th, according to a court filing, and says the proposed dates do not conflict with Trump's other criminal cases. Now, these filings indicate that Willis is seeking to quickly initiate the process of sharing discovery with all 19 defendants and wants to keep her word to hold a trial within 6 months. They also, I have some thoughts, but I'll just read the facts for you first before I give those. The relatively tight calendar Willis is proposing could be complicated by pretrial maneuvering by the defendants. Already on Tuesday, lawyers for former Trump chief of staff Mark Meadows filed a quick motion to transfer the case from state to federal court. Federal judge on Wednesday set a hearing on the matter for August 28th. And it's really highly speculated that Trump's probably gonna do the same thing, and several of the other co-conspirators, the defendants in these trials. I think that it's a really, I think that she's doing the right thing by setting the trial date to be quickly. I think that it's aspirational. I think that it will not happen that quickly. I think that a lot of these the co-conspirators, probably gonna, particularly Mark Meadows, will be successful in having their case removed from the state level to the federal level. We'll keep an eye out and report on that as it comes down. But I still think that even with a case with all of these co-conspirators, of course, discovery is gonna be difficult between all of them and all of their pretrial motions that they're gonna try to slow the process down with. But I think that she's still well within her rights to try to make the trial happen as fast as possible. And speaking of trials, Trump's got a lot of them coming up. We have a timeline of all of those from the New York Times. You can see, you can follow along, make, fill out your bingo card with Trump trials happening. So, Jackson, is it too aspirational that she wants to set this trial so soon? I mean, it is really soon, within 6 months from now. Although it doesn't conflict with any of his other trials, should it take a longer process? Should they try to gather as much evidence as possible, or do you agree with this quick trial date?
I mean, from my standpoint, you know, why not go forward as quickly as possible? The dude's got three other indictments. He was impeached twice, and he'd been in court more times than anybody can count on a million hands. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is his life. There's really nothing to guess. So, and what difference would it really make in regards to if she does it now or later? It's not gonna fly with the Republican base no matter what. You know, and hilariously too, you know, again, Donald Trump cannot keep himself from getting into more trouble. So again, he's gonna get in more trouble after this, whether it be because of what he does with campaign finances or something else. You know, him and his people, they spend the weekend, you know, calling Fani Willis, what were they calling, junior varsity Fani, like, what does that even mean? Like, what are you even trying to do? What are you even getting at? And then his entire campaign is nothing but trying to stay out of prison. You know, and it's not like that's a secret or anything. But I mean, this dude is trying to get Brian Kemp to change Georgia law so that he can stay out of prison. And Republicans are like, yep, that's my dude. You're not thinking about wages, you're not thinking about healthcare. But then if you ask these people this, they'll be like, well, yeah, you know, I do. I've been working for this company for 30 years and my pen. Like, they'll say the same things that everybody says, but then they just can't help but tap in to you know, that hatred for the others. You know, the gays and the blacks and the browns, you know, we gotta, because that's all Trump is. He's a wall from stopping the browns and the gays from being more brown and more gay. Because right, otherwise, y'all could just choose somebody else, right? So, but no, they're not gonna do that.
All right. And speaking of Trump, let's talk about what he had to say in this, I don't know, it's not a tweet. a truth that he posted to his social media site. He said, remember, all of these indictments, federal, state, and local, were conceived and generated by Crooked Joe Biden, not a great nickname, and Sleepy Joe had a lot more staying power, and his staff of radical left lunatics and thugs with the capital T for purposes of interfering with the 2020 presidential election. None of these trials should be allowed to begin prior to the election. Republicans might get tougher and must get tougher and smarter fast.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.